Hi, I'm Alex Dima, developer on the Visual Studio Online Monaco project. In this video, I will show you how to get productive with developing PHP websites in our hosted environment. I have just created a fresh new website from the Azure Gallery, and I've chosen CakePHP. Going into Monaco, I can see the files of the running website. Making a change in these files will reflect immediately. For example, I'm using Quick Open and going to the Home view to make a simple change. Monaco understands PHP and the boundaries between PHP and HTML. If I use Control slash to comment lines over a block of code in PHP, the lines get prepended with two slashes. And when I run the same action in HTML code, the code gets turned into a correct HTML comment. Now refreshing, and my changes are applied. To finish with setting up my environment, I will get Composer and use it to install PHP unit on this website. Let's create a batch file to download Composer. I'll simply call it getcomposer.bat. Don't worry, I've taken that from the getcomposer.org website. You can find it in the manual installation steps for Windows. I can now execute this batch file from the console. The console allows me to execute some predefined commands or batch scripts in the context of a website. Composer was successfully installed, and you notice a new file composer.far is shown in the Explorer. Let's create another batch file so we can actually run Composer. Okay, now that I have Composer set up, let's finally install PHP Unit. Speeding things up, PHP Unit is installed and Composer placed it in this vendor folder. Now I just need to include this generated autoload.php from CakePHP. I will use Quick Open again to go to core.php. Monaco also runs syntactic checks over PHP code and annotates the code with errors. You can hover over errors or press Ctrl dot to cycle through errors in a file. I've been writing too much JavaScript recently. I forgot the semicolon. Still, something is wrong. The output window should help me figure this out. It will show any PHP errors. Looks like I forgot a slash. Okay, this works now. My database has a simple to-dos table, and I will use CakePHP scaffolding to get something quickly up and running. CakePHP comes with a handy script for generating controllers, models, views, and even tests given just a database table, and it's called Bake. Let's see if the Bake script worked correctly. Looks like it did. There are my to-dos, and I can check that one off. That's what I like about PHP. It makes me feel so productive. Okay then, let's write a test now. I'm commenting out these lines because we won't be using the database just yet. You can use Ctrl-Shift-O to bring up quick outline in a PHP file. You can group symbols by typing colon. Now that we have our test, and since we've got PHP Unit installed, let's run it. CakePHP has a special test page, you just need to know where to find it. And there we have it. Now it's time to write awesome code. Thanks for watching, and please send us your feedback.